Walter Sorrells back with more tips for the knife maker. Today, doing a project with my new Atezr P20 Plus 20 watt laser engraving machine. So like I said, a couple weeks ago, I got an Atezr 20 watt laser engraving machine. Now, I've done a video a few months ago about using a laser engraver as a knife maker, just sort of generally. Today, I'm going to expand on that and do a pretty cool project with the Atezr. So, I'm going to start off today by telling you about the capabilities of the Atezr, you know, basically the ones that are most useful to you as a knife maker. And then, in the second half of the video, I'm going to actually use the machine and maybe help you see some reasons why a machine like this might fit into your knife making future. As always, like, share, and subscribe. Also, if you're thinking about jumping into knife making, by all means, pick up my free PDF with tips for getting started in the craft of making blades. Link in the description. Now, full disclosure, Atezr is sponsoring this video, so this is not my usual unbiased review. This is more about, here's a pretty cool machine, here's what it does, and here's a project that gives you a window into the kind of thing that it might be able to do for you. So take that for what it's worth. Now, if you aren't well acquainted with lasers, let's give you the lay of the land about what lasers can actually do and what they can't.
The business end of the machine is this little box right here, which contains a 20 watt diode laser. There are many kinds of lasers, some powerful enough to slice large hunks of steel in half. That's not what we're looking at here. This is for much more modest work. Now, this laser sits on a gantry that moves around at the beck and call of your computer. Same idea as a CNC mill, CNC router, 3D printer, whatever, except laser. Okay, so basics. What can you actually do with something like the Atezr? Basically, two things. You can burn relatively superficial designs or patterns and stuff, like this, which I burned into a piece of wood with the Atezr, or you can cut materials. Which materials? We'll get to that in a minute.
All right, now, before we go any further, unfortunately, I want to make some important points about, safety. So, with 20 watts, this is on the high end of, you know, the sort of home laser type category. Do not be fooled by calling this a home laser. This is a really powerful unit. It won't saw a car in half, but lasers like this can burn your eyes, they can start fires, they can produce toxic smoke. All three of these things are no joke. Wearing high quality safety goggles, taking sensible fire precautions, and dealing intelligently with potential fumes are really important aspects of running the Atezr or any similar machine. You just can't be complacent about it. And this is an absolute no-go zone for kids. Look, this is a really, really cool technology that I'm extremely high on. You just got to be serious about, you know, the safety implications of these machines.
Let me quickly run through the specs, then go over what you can expect to do with the Atezr. First, as I said, the machine has a 20-watt diode laser, which is right up towards the top of the power level for this general category of machine. The overall footprint of the machine is a little more than 2 feet square, with a working area of about 17 by 17, or 43 centimeters square. That means that the biggest design or cut that you can make can't exceed 17 inches on a side. Plenty, plenty, plenty of space for most knife makers. Limit switches, which are a nice feature that allow the machine to self-home each time you start it and not smash the head into the wall. The Atezr comes with safety goggles, a variable speed air assist, very nice, Wi-Fi compatibility. Anyway, price point right now, $1,200-ish. Of course, these things move around a lot. They're always specials and stuff, but that's where it is at the time of this video. If you're interested in buying one and helping out the channel, link down in the description that'll kick a few shekels back to the channel. So like I said, I did a video about lasers a few months ago that goes into a little more depth about what you can and can't mark or cut with this laser, so consult that if you want. But here's the basic drill. The center of gravity for these machines is wood. They cut wood, they mark wood, they engrave wood. More on that later. Stuff that's sort of wood adjacent also works great. Bone, antler, horn, leather, those kind of natural materials. And boy, do they all smell good. The Atezr can also cut and engrave most forms of plastic. What about metal? Well, the good news is that diode lasers really do play nice with steel. There's not enough power here to cut knife blade thicknesses. Marks fine, cuts not so much. So let me make a general point about laser cutters. I cannot begin to express how much better this is for putting logos or other marks on a blade than any other alternative. For years I've done logos using stencils and electrolysis. Hate it. This is so much more effective, more flexible, more powerful. Change your logo, want to add a serial number or model name, you don't have to send off to Timbuktu for a stencil. Total game changer in the logo department. If all you buy a laser for is to do logos, it'll be worth every cent. That said, the one general category of material that the Atezr and similar lasers can't touch is non-ferrous metals. Aluminum, brass, copper, that sort of thing, nada. Won't mark it, won't cut it, nothing. You can, however, use products like Ceramark and, yes, mustard to mark some non-ferrous metals. Now, let's talk cutting. As I'll show later, the Atezr will easily cut the depths of wood required to make knife handles. Getting 3/4-inch wood is no problem, and depending on the wood, you can run up to well over 1/2 inch, maybe even around 1 inch in perfect conditions. Though, frankly, I never got quite that kind of depth. Where laser cutters start to struggle is with oily woods and stabilized woods. What happens? Well, let me put this in simple terms. They catch on fire. Yeah, not that cool. Can be done, takes more care. Last point, how do you control it? These days, the most popular software for running lasers like this is Lightburn. It's what I bought and it works pretty well. So with the software, you'll set up what design you want to cut, along with all the variables in terms of speed, power, number of passes. It's fairly simple. Now, I could spend all day talking about the capabilities and nuances of running the Atezr, but I generally think you learn more by seeing the machine in operation. So let's jump in as I make a knife. First thing, recognize that you have to start with some kind of design. You could use Lightburn to produce that design, but honestly, it's not ideal. That's not really what it's made for. So I'm using the CAD program Fusion 360. There are all kinds of free CAD programs available. I just happen to use this. So I produce a 3D model first, but you don't have to. All you really need is an outline in the form of a DFX file. In Fusion 360, you just take your sketch and click this little button, and by golly, you got a DFX file you can just dump right into Lightburn. So what I'm focusing on for this project are these handle scales. I drew this little lightning bolt and extruded it into the handle. What this will allow me to do is to produce basically a negative and a positive for a handle inlay composed of two contrasting woods, in this case, hard maple and walnut. So I drop the DFX into Lightburn, use the frame tool to make sure the head's in the right place. Then crank away. Now, of course, I've done a few little tests to make sure that I'm cutting at the right speed and feed and all that. Now, at this point, I want to mention something about lasers. They smoke. I mean, when you're doing wood anyway. I ran my first laser for a while and basically smoked up my whole house. Really not that cool. So when I received the Atezr, the first thing I did was to build a little ducted enclosure. Very simple, just made out of plywood, and for a fan I'm using a shop vac. Now you could make it a lot quieter and a lot more effective, and you can put filters in it and all that, but this works. So now I can suck all the fumes out and vent them right out the window. I wouldn't trust this for dangerous fumes like something you might get from certain kinds of plastic, but it works great to get wood smoke out of the house. Anyway, I'll start by using the laser to cut the design. Two scales for each knife, two types of wood, each roughly 1/4 inch thick, so four different pieces of wood. It takes about a minute for each one, give or take. So if you wanted to batch some knives using this general process and produce a run of similar knives, you can do it in a pretty reasonable span of time. Check that out. Now I'll just switch the inlays to the contrasting wood. Back in the shop, I'll mix up some epoxy and some black color. A little bit of gooping and slathering, and we're set. Cured, we're ready to grind off the excess, flatten the scales, and apply them to the handle. Now to the disc grinder to flatten the scales. Of course, you could do this by hand on a piece of sandpaper. In fact, honestly, it works better that way. Now, the focus of this video is not on the blade making, but here's a cool thing. I can use the laser to mark the steel. Then there's no layout fluid, no scribing, no tracing, none of that. I can make as many duplicates as I want, then just grind to the lines, and it should match up pretty closely with the handle. Drill a couple holes, then it's off to the grinder. Now here's a neat little feature. We want this inlay to really stand out. So we don't want tacky looking holes in the design, the kind you'd normally have with handle pins. So I'll be using internal pins. With the tang acting as a drill guide or template, I'll just kiss the back surface on each scale a little under a tenth of an inch. I'm actually using an end mill instead of a drill to get a flat-bottomed hole, but you don't have to do it that way. Okay, heat treat. If you've been following me for a while, you've seen me do this a million times. Now, using a little double-sided tape and the internal pins to orient everything, I'll clean up the knife and the scales so everything lines up and the scales are properly shaped. Once everything's looking perfect, I'll pop them off again and clean up the blade. In this case, I'm using an abrasive blaster, but of course you could finish it any way you want. You can polish it, sand it, grind it, cerakote it, blue it, doesn't matter. The beauty of being able to do the handles ahead of time like this is that everything's all matched up and any surface finish that you've given to it is just going to stay there. For fun, we'll now use the laser to mark the blade. As you can see, this opens up a ton of possibilities if you're doing custom knife work. Somebody wants to buy something for their wife and have their name engraved on it or something, it's no problem to do that. The Atezr can burn anything from a pretty superficial, pale, grayish mark to a really deep gully that you can easily feel with your finger and that you won't polish out if you want to lay it in before, say, hand sanding your blade. Then back out to the shop and we'll epoxy the scales on. Now, is an internal pin system as robust as screws or peen pins or something like that? Well, obviously not, but this isn't the sort of knife that's intended for you to take out into the Amazon for your 4-month solo survival trip. For casual use, this thing will last forever. here's the final knife.
As you can see, the capabilities of the Atezr are pretty ridiculous. Like I said, it's worth the price of admission just for the purposes of making logos on your blades. But not just logos. This is just kind of off the top of my head list of some stuff that you could do along these lines. I mean, basically stuff that you're putting on the blade itself. You can put customized client names on blades. You can add serial numbers or sequential numbers for, you know, like a limited edition, 9 of 12 knives or that sort of thing. Change logos or touch marks at will without having to send off to a supplier for a punch or a stencil or anything like that. And that means, you know, every time you change models, you can put a new model number or new model name on that knife without having to do a whole bunch of new stuff. You can add writing to blade handles, quotations from Chairman Mao, Bible verses, text to the Second Amendment, whatever turns you on. You can add pictorial elements like, you know, a deer head or a picture of somebody's dog. It's crazy what you can do. I mean, forget about using it for cutting, which opens up all these things like inlays that we did today. Just engraving alone could add tons and tons of new design ideas and really expand your knife making capabilities. You'll think of dozens of things within 10 minutes of setting this thing up. So what can I say? I'm going to be using lasers like this Atezr in my shop for a long, long time.
Thanks for watching, guys. If you like what we're doing here, please subscribe and make sure that you click on that bell so you get notified of all the latest videos. Want to buy a knife from me? Check out my modern blades at tacticsarmory.com. Digging the channel? You can support our video making efforts on Patreon. You know, I've been banging away on these videos for like 10 years, so I hope you'll show some love for all that hard work. Link in the cards and descriptions. Finally, if you're interested in making Japanese swords, check out my full line of Japanese sword videos where I show how to forge Japanese swords as well as how to polish them and how to make fittings, handles, and scabbards. WalterSorrellsBlades.com.